I have additional information about the medallion. This parchment. I acquired it from one of our sources in Damascus.
A drawing of the complete medallion?
All 9 pieces. Before it was broken up and scattered.
Of course you've had this authenticated.
Naturally. The best opinion is that this parchment dates from 5,000 BC.
5,000 BC? But that means that the artist couldn't possibly have seen the original medallion.
I am quite aware of that. He undoubtedly was copying a copy of a copy. What we have now is absolute proof that the medallion once existed as a whole. Now tell me about the other piece you've located.
It belonged to an old man, an Indian in New Mexico. His name is Lucio. Periodically, I understand, he disappears into the desert, sometimes for months, sometimes for years. But recently, I've received some good news. He's returned to Taos.
With his piece of the medallion?
Exactly.
I want it. I'll leave the method of transaction up to you. I'd prefer that you purchase it from him. But if he refuses, deal with the situation as you see fit.
My uncle, look at him, watching. They'll be dead. Oh, my nature. I can't talk. When I wait, my chocolate. Oh, shall go, my nature.
Thank you. know, man. You know what we want. Just hand it over.
You okay?
You.
What?
You came.
Saw the smoke from the fire. How'd it start?
I don't know. It just sort of exploded.
Exploded?
Yeah. Look, a couple of Indians, young guys. They were giving the old man a bad time.
And what were you doing?
I was hitchhiking. I saw the shack. I wanted to get a drink of water. And then I saw some trouble and,
get him some water.
What's his name?
Lucio. Haven't seen him around 3 or 4 years, but I heard he was back. Sam?
I'm gonna get you some water.
You say you just dropped by for a drink of water, huh?
Yeah.
Buttons. Peyote. Where are you headed?
Taos.
You just got yourself a ride.
Lucio?
Please.
Oh, all right. Yeah, you can keep the junk. In here. Down there.
Why don't you lie down?
Hi.
Hi.
Shan Mullins.
Willie Longfellow.
Yeah, you're new in Taos.
Yeah.
I thought so. What brought you here?
It's a place I always wanted to see.
It's a heck of a place to see it from.
Yeah.
Oh, you could have done worse. I mean, the food's okay, and nobody really gives you a bad time, at least they haven't me.
You sound as though you know the place pretty well.
Yeah, I guess I am one of their better customers. Oh, nothing serious. You know, just some speeding tickets and stuff like that. Overnight and out. And what'd they get you on?
Well, it's a long story.
Here.
Thanks.
You gonna need a lawyer?
I don't know.
What about old Lucio?
Do you know him?
Everybody around here knows him. I guess everybody in Taos has always known him. Heck, I can remember when I was just a kid, he was an old man even then. Yeah, God only knows how old he is.
For Ginevra.
For who?
My grandchild. Take it to her.
Look, we won't be in here for long. Why don't you take it to her yourself?
Listen. Listen. So you will know. All men must die. Death is always with us. It is a waiting thing, standing behind us, always to our left. Watching us, always watching. Sometimes near, sometimes far. But always there, waiting to touch us at some unknown time. I have seen my death many times. He wears the face of a man. Your face.
Why didn't you tell us who you were?
I thought I did.
You know what I mean. Your father's a federal judge.
How'd you find that out?
Well, what's that? From Boston.
Quick. Where'd they take Lucio's body?
The morgue.
He said that he had a granddaughter. Said her name was Gennara?
Yeah, Gennara Wantes. She lived in Rancho de Taos, right across the street from the church.
Has she been notified?
Well, it's the coroner's job to contact the next of kin in a case like this.
I'm looking for Gennara Wantes.
What for?
Are you Gennara?
Who are you?
Your grandfather sent me.
You a friend of his?
Well, I knew him.
Well, why did he send you?
I have something for you.
What?
May I come in?
Well, what is it you have for me?
Some news.
You said you had something.
Wait. Didn't the coroner's office tell you? Your grandfather died last night. If you want to make arrangements, I can tell you who to call.
What did my grandfather give you?
Well, he wanted you to have this. You're not Gennara.
Arturo!
Let's have it.
Forget it!
All right, hand it over.
Thank you.
Hey, I'd be glad to buy one, but I had to borrow money to get out of jail. Thanks.
How'd you know I was in Rancho de Taos?
Heard a jailer say you might find Janera there.
You know her?
I lived in Taos most of my life. I know practically everybody, more or less.
Yeah?
Anyway, I knew Jen didn't live there anymore. Hey, what was that beef all about, anyway?
I don't know. I think it had something to do with this. You know why anybody'd be so interested?
I never seen anything like it. But you gotta understand about old Lucio. Yeah, there's all kinds of stories about him. He's kind of a legend around here, you know? He'd walk between Taos and somewhere down in Mexico. Heck, you could find Indians all over. Say they seen him disappear in thin air, Gulf waterfall, stuff like that. He was sort of a holy man, you know? They call him Diablero.
Well, they use peyote for religious purposes, don't they?
Yeah, you know about that stuff?
Yeah, read about it.
You believe any of it?
Yeah, some of it.
Well, anyway, those two punks back there, they probably think that thing's worth a few bucks.
They went through an awful lot of trouble for just a few bucks.
You got a point there.
You know anybody in Taos who'd know what this is? What it's worth?
Yeah, sure. Hop in.
That's it?
Can't do better.
Okay. Well, thanks.
Thanks.
Yeah, thanks for charging to the rescue.
Hey, look, those two guys back there might just take another run at you.
No, I think I can handle it from here.
Well, you like to go it alone, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, I guess I do.
Okay.
Take care.
This is old, quite old, in fact. I might keep it on consignment for you, although there's not much market for it this time of year, with all the tourists gone. What would you want for it?
Well, you tell me. What do you think it's worth?
Well, it's hard to say. Some tourists and collectors will pay very good money for the most unexpected things.
For example?
Well, if the right person comes along, who knows? It's a strange business. Just last summer, I had a couple of Zuni gods carved out of wood. And they actually looked like a couple of pieces of firewood. About 10,000 for the pair. This is an interesting piece. I could give you a couple of hundred for it, if you want to sell it outright.
Well, I'll think about it.
10?
10 what?
$100,000.
That's some jump.
Call it a hunch.
No thanks. Never was one for hunches.
Not even if it's a $5,000 hunch?
You play hunches like there's no tomorrow, don't you? You should watch that.
Yes, operator. I need to call London, please. Person to person to Mr. Raymond Stryker at 46247.
And even after I offered him $5,000, he walked out on me. So what do you want me to do now?
Bloody idiot had it in his hand, and he let it get away.
Post-mortems bore me, Stryker. We're at fault for dealing with amateurs. You'll be leaving for New Mexico immediately.
Glenn, if I have any further need of your services, I'll be in touch with you.
Miss Wanted? Miss Wanted? Anybody home?
Hey. You have trouble finding the place?
What are you doing here?
I'm having a beer. You want one?
Why didn't you tell me you knew Gennaro?
Well, I thought I did. I mean, how would I know she didn't live in Rancho de Taos if I didn't even know her? As a matter of fact, Jen and I are old friends. Good old friends.
Then why didn't you tell me where she lived?
Well, after Rancho de Taos, I began to wonder.
About what?
You. Why you all of a sudden got so interested in old Lucio's hunk of metal and how much it was worth?
Wouldn't you be interested after what happened?
Sure. But you see, Glenn's another old friend of mine. And I talked with him after you left. Oh, he tried to play it cool. But I know him. He was drooling.
You seem to be making a career out of keeping track of me.
Well, you and the medallion.
Why?
Look, what's to keep you from finding Gennaro and saying that you know old Lucio's keepsake isn't worth much? But you've taken a fancy to it, so you'd like to have it. And you talk her into selling it to you all nice and legal.
You got a great imagination.
And you go back to Glenn and peddle it to him for what it's really worth.
Oh, I see. So what you're really doing is you're protecting Gennaro's interests.
Yeah, right. Now you got it.
Where is she?
She's at work. Hey, look, if you just want to leave that thing and be on your way, go ahead.
No, I'll wait.
Don't you trust me?
I trust myself more.
Hello? This is Miss Wantes. Who is this calling? Yes, Mr. Stryker. What is this all about? Yeah? Yeah? I've been notified. $20,000.
I'm fixing myself a sandwich. You want one?
Yeah, sounds good.
What do you got there?
You read it?
Nah, but Jen told me about it. It's all about a guy sort of like old Lucio.
Your door was open.
Who are you?
I'm Willie Longfellow.
Longfellow? You were with my grandfather last night when he died.
Well, then you know.
The sheriff said that you had helped him.
Yes.
I wish I could tell you what happened. But I can't. Not so it would make any sense. It's very hard to explain.
You don't have to. I knew my grandfather.
Hey, Jan. How are you?
Jan, what are you doing here?
I'm just fixing myself a sandwich. Well, you win some, you lose some.
Oh, Janelle, your grandfather wanted me to give you this.
My grandfather carried this with him for as long as I can remember. I first saw it when I was about 10. He had taken me into the desert. It was night. He built a small fire and pulled his blanket around his shoulders. He'd hold the medallion cupped in his hands, and he sat there for hours, gazing up at the sky, as if he was waiting for something, expecting something.
Did your grandfather tell you the significance of the medallion?
No. Why?
I think you should know that somebody tried to take it away from me.
Oh, come on, man. What are you trying to scare her for?
I'm not trying to scare her. I just want to warn you. Somebody wants that very badly.
Look, if we're going the warning route, maybe I should include you.
Okay, let's stop this, all right? I thank you for telling me. I hope you understand, but I really want to be alone.
Sure. Sure, I understand.
Jen, honey, look, I...
Jen, I don't need your help. I've managed very well without you for quite some time. Is the curator there, please?
I'll ring Dr. Henderson for you. He said his name was Raymond Stryker, an art dealer from London. He'll be in Taos tomorrow.
And he's prepared to pay you $20,000 for it, sight unseen?
Yeah. Do you have any idea what it's worth?
I don't have any idea what it is. Do you know where your grandfather got it?
From his father, I was told, and his father from his.
He never talked about it?
No, but... he always regarded it very reverently.
These markings are like no language or calligraphy I know about. There is a slight resemblance to Sumerian.
But that was in the Middle East. How could that be possible?
The whole world is littered with riddles of history. And this piece of metal, if it is metal, looks like gold, only it isn't. I'd like to take it to Santa Fe for some tests at the college's metallurgical lab. Gennaro, if all you want to know is what it's worth, take it to an art dealer. If you want to know what it is, leave it with me.
I have a feeling I don't want to know what it is, but take it. Now, it was already getting very, very hot. Very hot. The sun was right overhead, something like it is now. They knew that they had to get out there on the road if they were going to find that river. And once they found that river, they knew they could follow it downstream. They heard that there was a cave, a big, dark cave.
It is, Miss Wantez, isn't it?
Yes.
I'm Raymond Stryker. I hope I'm not intruding. But I thought if you had made up your mind about the medallion, we could...
I haven't decided yet. I didn't expect you so soon. I want to think about it some more.
Well, I can understand that, Miss Wantez. But I would like to remind you that $20,000 is a lot of money and far and above the normal price for such an item.
There's something I don't understand, Mr. Stryker.
Oh, what is that?
How did you hear about such an item in London?
Oh, my dear young lady, I'm in a very competitive profession. Miss Wantez, it's my business to know. Of course, now, if you're hesitating because of price...
It's not price.
Well, what is it then? Sentiment?
In a way.
Well, only you can put a price on that.
Well, then I'll need more time.
Very well, then. I'll call you this evening, say. Oh, one more thing. In the art world, sentiment is a big factor in any transaction, and I do take it into account. But I would like to give you one small word of advice. It usually is a big mistake to value sentiment too highly. Until this evening.
I just came to see the collection. And you?
I'm waiting for Dr. Henderson.
Yeah, I read his books. Well, I'm glad I got a chance to say goodbye.
You're leaving Taos?
Yeah.
Do you have to go? I mean, right away?
No, not if I have a reason to stay.
I'm frightened.
Oh, look, if it's because of what I said...
No, it's not that.
Well, then what?
A man named Raymond Stryker.
Shan Mullins is just a local kid looking for a buck.
And that's all you know about him?
Yeah, so far.
See what else you can find out.
All right.
How long have you known Shan Mullins?
Quite a while.
Are you good friends?
We were, right after I got out of school, but not for long. Nothing ever lasts for long with Shan, especially friendships. That is, unless you have something he can't get anywhere else.
I guess he figures that now you do.
I have something for you. And a confession.
Castaneda?
I had it with me for about 3 hours driving around looking for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I saw you looking at it near my apartment, so I thought maybe you'd like to read it.
Well, I already have. I first ran across it in Saigon. This book is what brought me back through New Mexico.
What about after New Mexico?
Well, I don't know. I'll go home, probably. Get a job. Get some more school. I can't spend my life looking for something I'm not sure even exists.
At least you try. I don't seem to have the courage to do even that.
Well, maybe you've already found it here in Taos.
I called him to find out if he knew where you were. He didn't, so I asked him to meet me.
Hey, she found you, huh? What's this all about?
I photographed the piece and gave copies to The heads of both the departments of archaeology and anthropology at the university. The markings on the piece are just as much of a mystery to them as they are to me. But we did determine one thing of significance.
And what was that?
Look closely at the trident. Now, this. That's a photo of the trident on the cliff above the Bay of Pisco in Peru. The trident points directly inland toward the plain of Nazca. It's visible for miles.
It looks like a landing field.
There is a theory that it was exactly that. The landing field on the plain of Nazca for ancient astronauts from another planet.
What?
Now look at this. The trident is a fairly common symbol in most cultures, of course. So it could be written off as coincidence. Except for this. This one thing. Spectroscopic analysis showed an unknown alloy of what? Metal? I presume so. Particularly since its degree of hardness was greater than that of a diamond. Then, for some reason, don't ask me why, I asked for a thermoluminescence test.
What's that?
A method of dating pottery.
Only this isn't pottery in any way, shape, or form. Nothing like it has ever been seen by anybody on this earth. Except for superficial dust and oil from constant handling, the material wasn't aged or worn. Could have been made yesterday. But it wasn't.
Did you get a reading?
We shouldn't have, but we did.
How old is it?
At a minimum, 50 to 55,000 years.
Born here. That's the elder's house over there, and that's the sacred mountain beyond. That's where my grandfather will be buried. Only my people are permitted there, so you'll have to wait here until afterwards. I'm going to go seek the elder's council now about the medallion. I have a feeling it affects all of us.
I'm gonna look around.
Find a cold beer, let me know, okay?
Waiter, Gennaro called in. Going to Taos Pueblo. She's burying her grandfather.
Longfellow and Mullins with her?
Well, let's see if our friend Glenn can at least find that out.
I've spoken with the elder, and he's heard about the medallion and the power and the mysteries it's supposed to contain. He acknowledges my right, but not my right to share it with others or with you. That decision has to be made by a power higher than the elder. It's to be made by Willow Lane.
Willow Lane?
The night spirit. The power of the smoke. It is to be made tonight after Lucio's funeral.
Look, Jen, what good is...
Let me finish. The elder has agreed to let you be present at the summoning because my grandfather trusted you with the medallion and because I want you to share it. But you're not Indian, so you must earn that right. Before you accept, you must understand that this is not just a ceremony. It's a trial and a judgment by Willow Lane. He is a most remorseless judge. If he does not approve of you, he could cause you great harm, even death.
The night spirit, power of the smoke.
Where are you going?
Find some place to get a beer.
You mean you're not going through with it?
Well, didn't you hear? You gotta believe. You see, I just don't believe. I'll pick you up after the rain dance.
Be another 500 if and when you persuade Ms. Wantes to sell.
Well,
Well, Glenn offers Willie Longfellow $5,000. Then you offer Gennaro $20,000. Now you come to me talking peanuts. Look, Stryker, if I persuade Jen to sell that thing, maybe I'll give you a shot at it, maybe I won't. But if I do, don't come around me talking nickels and dimes.
He asks if you understand the consequences if you do not pass Willow Lane's judgment.
Sorry.
Sit.
Thank you.
identical.
Except this.
Well, the elder must have been trying to tell us something.
Oh, that old man was probably so spaced out on mescal, he didn't know whether he was afoot or on horseback. He couldn't even have told you his name.
Let me show you something. This is a reconnaissance photo of a World War II bombing range out here in the desert, taken by the Air Force in 1943. If you look at this, study it enough, you come up with this. While you were gone, I went back to Santa Fe to dig through the university's library again. I came up with this in some old storage stacks. This. It was found in China 80 years ago and acquired by the British Museum. A courier was to take it to London to be examined. He left Shanghai by ship, and that's the last that was ever seen of him. Or of this. It's obvious the piece we have and the piece found in China are part of a whole. The medallion was broken up, and the pieces scattered. But how a piece that hard could be cut, and when, why, and by whom, only God knows. Judging by the piece we have and the picture in that book, the medallion could have been separated into 9 pieces. 9 pieces fitting together and giving us...
What?
Answers to questions we're afraid to ask. Secrets we don't want to hear. Proof of what we prefer to call legends, myths, folklore. Think of the mysteries, stories that won't go away, that refuse to die. They're found everywhere, in every ancient culture. Tales of gods that came to Earth from the sky in their machines of smoke and fire, then left, promising to return. Could it be that this is a message they left behind? Or could it be, could it possibly be that they're keeping their promises and returning?
You mean like UFOs?
Perhaps UFOs.
Well, I think I can accept that, but what was the point of what happened the other night, of the elder's drawing?
That drawing indicates an area almost certainly to be Tyree Gorge.
Tyree Gorge? Hey, there's nothing out there.
How do you know?
Because I've been there.
Have you ever looked at it? Really looked at it? Wondered about it? Thought about it? Asked yourself what might be down there? What the medallion the elder's drawing may be pointing to?
Like what? Wait a minute. You're asking us to go out there and look.
Yes.
Oh, you're really something.
Where are you going?
Well, I'll tell you where I'm not going. Tyree Gorge, and if you and Willie want to go tramping around that hellhole looking for God knows what, all I gotta say is good luck.
Shan!
Well, let him go.
We can't. He's the only one who's been up and down every canyon around here. Shan! You've been there. You know that gorge. Shan, help us. Look, if we don't find anything, I'll sell that medallion and we'll divide the money 3 ways.
Why do it the hard way, Jen? You're not gonna find anything out there, so sell it now. Look, that guy Stryker is still registered at the inn. I know, because I check. I'll drive you over there right now.
No, I don't need you to sell it to Stryker. Now or later.
Jen. Jen! Look, say we do go out there and we don't find anything. How do I know you still won't stall about selling?
I promise.
Well, how can I be sure of that?
I wasn't the one who broke the last promise we made one another.
You got a deal.
How far is it to the gorge?
Just a few miles. You could hide the Pacific Ocean out there.
Yeah. Well, we better get started.
I'll drive it closer to the edge.
What are you going to do?
Use it as a dead man. Go down on a rope. You ever done any climbing, Willie?
Yeah. Matter of fact, I have.
Hang on. Hang on tight.
Work our way downstream.
Tall, frosty ones you get at Joe's, you know what I mean?
What is that down there?
That's a fork in the Rio Grande and a Rio Nido.
What is it?
A trident's a fork, right?
Yeah.
This could be it.
What are you talking about?
If we drew a straight line from the point where the rivers meet, it would end up somewhere on the cliff on this side. That could be it.
Man, you have really gone off the deep end.
Come on, let's get going.
Okay. Fun's fun, but I've had it. You can tell she has too if you'd stop long enough to look at her.
Is that right?
I don't know. It all just seems so hopeless.
All right, look. Why don't we rest here for a bit? And we'll go back to camp.
No, not camp, Taos.
And we'll get something to eat, and we'll have some sleep.
Well, forget it.
We'll talk about it in the morning.
There's nothing to talk about because I'm through and so is Jen. Tell him. Tell him.
Shen.
Look, Jen, we had a deal.
Alone.
Come on, wait a minute.
Mouth of a small cave or something. Look, maybe we can dig it out.
Dig? Oh, come on, man. The only way you could move that is to blast.
Well, why don't we go to Taos and get some dynamite?
Hold it. Oh, look, there's no point in all of us going back. I can make it faster alone. You and Jen can move our gear down here while I'm gone. But luckily, I ought to be back by tomorrow noon.
And when I was about five, my mother and father left Taos Pueblo and went to Santa Fe. For years, we kept traveling from place to place. Roswell and Gallup, Albuquerque. It didn't end until my father died. By then, I didn't know who I was or where I belonged.
Look, for whatever it's worth, there is such a thing as too much belonging and too many ties. I mean, not just who you are and what you are, but who you're going to be and what people expect you to be. Not out of selfishness, but out of love, because that's the way it's always been. I guess what I'm trying to say is that there's not that much difference between your grandparents living beside the Chama River in New Mexico and the Longfellows living beside the Charles in Boston. I mean, they both lived the way they've always lived, and that's the way things have always been, and that can be secure and comfortable, or it can be a kind of death.
You're not going back to Boston?
No. I guess I say I am because
It's the easy answer. Well, maybe I will go back someday. I mean, it's home. It's there waiting for me. I'm just not sure.
Listen. I barely knew you the other day when I went looking for you. Somehow I knew I could trust you. But more than that, I needed you. Whatever it is that you're looking for, it brought you to Taos and to me. Whatever it is, it's going to take you away. There'll be people, all kinds of people, who will trust you and need you. People who will find something for themselves out of your searching. I said I envied you. I envy them even more.
You don't believe me.
I didn't say that.
You don't have to.
Listen to me, Mullins. I do know a little about this country. And Tyree Gord's covered a lot of territory.
I told you, I'll give you a map that'll take you right to where they are.
Oh, it's a map you want me to buy for $30,000. A map that will take us any place, but the right place.
Look, I guarantee...
That's enough. That is enough. I had Wheeler ask some questions about you. You're part bum and part would-be con man. But I know you're not fool enough to think that I would buy that pig in the poke you're trying to sell me. You want $30,000. You shall have it. Just bring me the medallion.
That hot and cold running water. Did you know about it?
I've heard about it.
Yeah?
There's a legend that all life began in a place like this. Where warm springs are right beside the cold waters of the river. Would you like to hear it?
Yeah.
Well, according to the story, the spring waters are the waters of the earth, the mother. And the rivers are the waters of the sky, the father. And when the snows of the mountains melted and the icy waters of the rivers of the sky flooded down and engulfed the waters of the earth, the mother, life began.
Mm.
Did you like it?
Mm.
I'm glad. Because I just made it up.
It's very funny.
All set?
Well, only one way to find out. I'll get a lantern. Okay, I'll take those. Just give them to me.
What are you doing?
Now look, it doesn't have to be this way. You see, I got Stryker up to 30,000 just for Lucio's. Now with another one, we could have his tongue hanging down to his knees, don't you see?
30,000? What is the matter with you? Look around. Don't you know what we found? 30,000, 30 million. You can't put a price tag on this.
Now, you're being stupid, Willie. You see, you're being stupid. Now, don't you see what we can get for delivering two of these to Stryker? Yeah, we can.
Kill him.
Stryker.
He's dead. He hit his head in a rock. He's washed downstream. Medallions are with him.
Both gone?
Well, then all this is for nothing.
Please stay with Shan. I'll go back to Taos. Bring a doctor back to take care of him.
Wait, I'll go with you to the raft and get the canteen.
Hey, Willie. Be careful.
I will.
Gennaro.
What?
No one can prove whether other pieces exist.
No, but if they do exist, they may be buried, covered forever by earthquakes or landslide, like the cave at Tyree Gorge only hours after you left.
And we're the only ones alive who saw that tomb.
Yep. An act of nature. Or an act of the gods. Doesn't that make you curious to look further?
We don't know what we'll have, even if I find the other pieces.
Perhaps nothing more than a curiosity. Or you may find something beyond evaluation. The secret of who we are. How we got here, where we came from. Did we walk out of the Garden of Eden, or did we crawl out of some primeval sea? Or have we always been fascinated by the stars, wondering about them, haunted by them? Because they're lights along some half-remembered road we traveled once. Isn't that a search worth making?
Come with me.
I can't.
Look, the other night, it wasn't...
I know,
it wasn't...
I know.
Then why not?
Because I've done my exploring. I had to find peace between two worlds. Worlds as different as Lucio's and Jan's. I can't risk losing that. I can't ask you to stay. Because you're still searching. Lucio trusted you. He knew you. I trust you. want you to take both pieces. Find the rest. Find that mystery. Find yourself, Willie. As if he was waiting for something, expecting something.